Today on As the Vice Turns, the story of a devilishly handsome and incorrigibly stubborn young man trying to get his Frankenstein Ryobi drill press turned into a milling machine. Whilst I couldn't agree with you more, this is an iterative process and the parts canon. She is a demanding mistress. So, ever onwards, we are blasting more parts at this to get her to finally, chooch.
A little of this, a little of that, eye of newt, dick of the vice. Fuck yeah.
Exhibit the first. Straight from the Big Rock Candy Mountain, Mao's Poundland, ER-12, M-12, ER-20, my mistake. Not super familiar with collets. I'm getting there. So, this is the same kind of thing that you'd buy from the Grizzly Tools. Of course, there's no point in buying from Grizzly, as we saw with that cracked bullnose. However, AliExpress, this is obvious, it's got to be an outlet for backdoor stuff, third shift stuff out of Chinese factories, and stuff that doesn't go through, or doesn't meet QC, rather, Q out of C. Check it out. See the taper there? The taper? Holy fuck. It's right daddy wampus, so it's not even engaging. The collet's not even engaging on that taper. Instead, it's hitting this offset here. So, if you buy this and expect to use it right off the hop, you are sorely mistaken. You're going to need to buy a lathe at the same time in order to cut that so we can get at the chamfer in here instead of hitting on this shoulder. Kind of silly. You can see the distance there. Just right off in the rhubarb. Good thing it's soft Chinesium. Mao, he thinks of everything. Exhibit the second from the Big Rock Candy Mountain via Germany. A Proxxon XY table. This is a Proxxon too, but a Proxxon. I don't know. I don't know how you say it. But this is a little bit smaller, and then this is a little bit larger. Larger Gibbs and aluminum instead of plastique, you know. Just more skookum, hopefully. Might be a total piece of junk. Cost me €150, something like that. €180, actually. So not cheap. Not cheap by any means. Still cheaper than a proper milling machine. Oh yeah. Relatively quick and painless. The bris of the misshapen Chinese dingus end quickly and easily dispatched with moil-like efficiency. I also put a stud in here because when we heat this socket up, remember this is a Morse Taper 2. Morse Taper does not hold when there's loading this way. It shakes loose. So what we need to do is heat the fuck out of this. Normally, there would be, on a milling machine, there would be a drawbar that takes the male end and jams it into the female socket. Right cock stiff. Unfortunately, in this case, we don't have the drawbar and there ain't no room for it. So what we can do is we heat this up, that differentially expands it, we jam that in, and when it cools, she's in there for good or worse. Sure to be a revolutionary idea. Huh? Huh? Now, you got your knickers in a knot over $100 drill press bearings. This ain't the channel for you, partner. Conduct. And we'll just apply the proper torque, super accurately measured.
There we go.
While the air clears here, mightn't as well use the fasteners, what come with the thing. They might not work. We'll see. Kind of tough to get in there. Maybe if I go back the other. Whoa. Lay it back. Nah, how's that? I'll figure it out. Click. Engage the laser. We're at about a half a pucker here. The safety squints. Ain't gonna cut it on this one. My glasses, two condoms, mother on speed dial. It's nice that it's right at right at face level too. That's extra especial. Okay. Let's move this out of the way. Okay. Here we go. Rather anticlimactic, still scared the shit out of me. Oh, there we go. Rattled right out of her. Rookie mistake, the bane of all sketchy setups, climb milling. Will not climb mill. So, nothing for it but we're gonna super glue this in place. Wipe off the excess. We don't want to look like a bunch of butchers. Once again, for the second time, also filming in potato vision. Bloop. Contact. Well, that ain't too bad. I've done worse on the Bridgeport. I'll try some aluminum. Contact. Got the staggers and jags. Shakes like a pair of boots on agitate, but looks like she gets the job done. Better than a file, anyway. Oh, fuck yeah! Cheapo drilling machine converted to a milling machine. Where there's a will, there's a wake. Yes, uglier than a stump fence, but did it work? Indeed it did. What you need is this type. It's stiff enough. It's got the ways, the dovetail ways, far enough away so it doesn't have a bad case of the rattle traps. And adjustable gibs, loose and tight and so forth. You need the ready rods on the table. What the ready rods do, they form a triangle. So you got to get that triangulation going. That makes a tension member. Stiffens her up. Proof in the pudding. In the eating of the currants. Then you got to get yourself the Morse Taper 2, depending on the socket you got, and the ER20 collet. That rigidifies it, makes it nice and centered. So total indicated runout isn't as bad as with the 3-jaw Jacob's chuck. And then we just super glue that in place. Shh, don't tell anybody. that's pretty much all there is to her. You get yourself, you know, who doesn't have a drill press? So what you're looking at is this $200 XY table, and you sort of, you know, it's not a milling machine, obviously. It's not a Bridgeport milling machine, but can you mess around? Can you have some fun? Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Thanks for watching. Give your dick an advice. The barking spiders are musky this time of year, I'll tell you that.